Hey guys, so I'm calling it done now. As with every build I've ever done and every video I've ever done about a finished build, I'll say it again. There's probably more I could do. And I always reserve the right to come back and do more. And sometimes I actually do come back and do more work to it. Oftentimes I'll just sit and I'll look at a piece sitting on the shelf and I'll just take it off the shelf and do more work to it. Most of the time I take it down and I fix it because something's broken on it. But sometimes when I do that, I actually end up improving it. I've done it to a couple of kits now. And sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. There's little things I could probably do with this. I don't know, I may actually add some snow to this at some point. I'm not sure where I would add it to. Maybe just around the edges and stuff. Maybe clumps of somewhat melted snow. I have some stuff that does really good melted snow, like a slushy, snowy look. And I may, at one point, add some of that to it. The whole point of this diorama, the story, it's supposed to take this one picture, and that's of Feldwebel Hermann in his original tank, his early production tank. It's quite thoroughly stuck, as you can tell, and it looks as though it has slid down a bank and got itself stuck. I can't tell for sure if that's exactly what happened in the picture, and there's really no description as to what exactly happened in the picture. But it looked like it may have. But either way, that's where I got the inspiration for this. So we have the Feldwebel here, still in command of his tank. He's in there, he's giving orders to the driver and stuff like that. And they're getting ready to recover the tank after it slid off the bank. But the story behind this, based on that one photograph, was the tank was engaged in operations, and it was up here on the bank, right, originally, and was firing at a target that's in that direction, off in the distance, and was reversing. And as it was reversing, the driver obviously can't see. The commander can, but there's a reason why Hermann was known as the hero of the Soviet Union, is because he kept getting his tank stuck. So he may not have been very good at telling his driver where he was and stuff like that. So they were backing up, and they got to the edge so that the rear corner of the Tiger was overhanging the edge of the roadway, and it gave way, and the tank turned and slid down the bank. And when it hit the bottom, it straightened itself out a bit. And as it did that, it got stuck, right? So it literally just slid on an angle, like the back corner gave way, and it turned and slid down, and then the rest of the tank kind of followed suit. That's why the mark is skinnier at the top, and then it widens out at the bottom, because the tank turned on its way. That's what I tried to convey. Whether or not I did it, I don't know. But, you know, I'm hoping it, that's what it looks like to me, but I've been staring at this thing for 3 weeks, so, you know, it's going to look like all sorts of things to me. But, you know, as things go, I kind of like the way it looks. I think it's all right. But as I had said earlier, there's more I could probably do. There's more things, more different types of vegetation I can add to the bramble. Like I said, I could add clumps of snow, melted snow in around certain areas. I had at one point considered adding a smoke stack to the shack. That sort of thing. Maybe some standing grass along the top edge here. Just for something to do. Maybe another clump of trees over here. The problem with doing that, though, is the more you do it, the busier it gets, and the busier it gets, and eventually no one knows what they're looking at anymore. It just looks like a big, complicated mess. So it's best not to do it while you're thinking about it. It's best to do it later. I mean, you make a few notes, stick it on a post-it note, and, you know, tack it on the side of the diorama, and then come back to it like a month or two or three later, and then think about doing those, making those changes. It's just, I find it better. It works better that way. So the rest of the story is, it's the day after combat operations had completed, and the crew either stayed with the tank overnight or had fled and then returned to the tank. And they're engaged in recovery operations. This is the recovery crew. This is recovery crew up here. These guys may be from a separate bird panther, which isn't in the scene. I believe they had a crew of four. So these guys may be a second crew. And these guys here are the regional commanders. You can tell by the way they look. This guy here would be like a company commander. These two fellas here are top brass, right? One of them would be a field marshal, this fella here. And this guy here, I'm not really sure what he'd be. Probably, most likely a field marshal as well. Maybe a colonel. I don't know. I'd have to go and look up my ranks. I don't memorize that kind of thing. So, either way, they had ridden up with the company commander to see what the holdup is. And I just love the way this guy is standing there, you know, tapping his wrist at these fellas down here, saying, you know, let's move things along. We have a war to conduct, kind of thing. So, there's still a little tiny bit too much shine on these figures. Some of them I don't much care for. Most of it's gone now, but it just has the slightest hint of shine to it. I don't know, I'm hoping that over time, as the paint cures, it'll go away. But we'll see. So anyway, so like I said, I'm calling this done, and in a few minutes I'll put up a slideshow, and you guys can take a closer look. If you want detailed pictures, like really close-up pictures and stuff, you'll have to go to the forum to see those, because that's where I put them. So Dev and James, I really appreciate you guys hosting the group build. I know I had a great time building my piece, and right now I'm having a fantastic time watching all the other pieces that are being built. There are some spectacular pieces being built, and I love a good tiger build, so I'm certainly enjoying watching what everyone's building. There are so many incredible pieces being built, and some very expensive ones too. Some of the kits that are being put together is not exactly cheap, and the guys are kind of going all out with some of the aftermarket and then big elaborate dioramas, and there's a couple of them that are just astounding, bigger than this, and it's going to be impressive. It's going to be, a couple of them are actually tiny. They're 72nd scale, but they're going to be more complicated than this thing, and I can't wait to see what those are. There's a couple of them I'm really watching, and yeah, there's some astounding things. So thanks, Dev and James, for putting that on, and you know, I'm not going to go into the reasons why you're hosting it or anything like that, but I do appreciate it, and I do appreciate everyone who's taking part. I'm not going to go into it in detail and stuff, but it does warm my cockles, and I do thank you. I really do. You guys are all silly people for thinking I deserve anything like that. So, another little thing I want to just remind everybody that there are prizes, a prize, being given away at the end of this group build. My daughter and Devin's two little ones are going to be the judges, so prepare yourself for that level of skill in the judging. So that'll be an interesting thing to see how that that turns out. I'm not, of course, entered in the contest, and neither is Dev or James, because they're the hosts. It would be silly if I was in there too. So that's another thing that I think it's on April 1st is when the group build ends, so we'll see what happens after that. Should be interesting. I know my daughter's really looking forward to doing the judging. She's kind of really excited about it. So I'll see how that goes. Anyway, I look forward to the rest of the builds. And anyone else who wants to join in, get a hold of Devin Bliss or James Duvall on either through YouTube or through the forum, or I think you can find them both on Facebook too, through the International Scale Modeler Facebook page, and let them know you want in, and they'll sort things out. Until then, you guys be good. Keep your stick on the ice. Bye for now.